Hi, and welcome to the sixth episode of Jeroboam's Underground Wine Club. My name is Ben Price with Ogo Initiative.
And I'm Eric Russo with Russo's International Market.
And we are talking Pinot Noir today. Pinot Noir is a very elegant grape, light-bodied red wine grape, also used in champagne. And it is a, we're going to try it from three out of the four major Pinot Noir regions in the world. We've got one from Burgundy, France. We have one from the Willamette Valley in Oregon, and then we have one from the Russian River Valley in California. We are not going to try one from the fourth, which is Central Otago Bay in, or Central Otago in New Zealand, because Eric and I can't hold our wine that well. So we're going to get started. Pinot Noir, typically a cooler grape, a cooler climate grape. It'll be very light-bodied. We should be able to see our, fingers through the glass, through the wine, as we drink this. Very thin-skinned grape. And so, of all of the reds that we've been drinking, you can just see how light that is in comparison. It's kind of hard to pick up, but really like a garnet cranberry color. Mm-hmm. Very clear around the edges. This is a 2012 Gevrey-Chambertin, which is in the Côte de Nuit region of Burgundy, in the famous Côte d'Or. You'll see the alcohol in this is 13% light for a red wine, and you can see it doesn't, you know, the tears kind of run fast. Let's give it a smell. Okay. Earth,
smoky,
lots of forest floor, kind of mushroomy kinds of flavors coming out. Cherry as well, the fruits, the cherry, I think.
Yeah, definitely. Cherry is the only fruit I'm really getting.
But a lot of other interesting stuff underneath it.
Lots of oak, but not
lots of
typical.
Wood.
Oh, yeah,
yeah,
it's,
lots of wood.
It's more like cigar.
Yes.
Smell.
Yep.
Smokiness.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, and a lot of just like it, what you imagine like when you're hiking in the woods and your feet kind of kick up that stuff, that stuff that your feet kick up in the woods, that kind of forest floor.
I was gonna say, as Victor would say, forest floor.
Forest floor. Yes. There's a little brighter fruit in there underneath it all. Can't tell what it is, but maybe a little strawberry or something underneath. Can you give it a taste?
Yeah, I almost feel like that cherry's smells a little bit sour.
Yep, yeah, for sure. Ready?
Yeah.
All right. Incredibly pure fruit. Cherries,
yeah.
And probably some other stuff underneath there that I'm still, some other fruit
elegant.
As well. Yeah, but powerful. It's a super, this is an incredibly focused wine where I can feel it from the tip of my tongue, like really tracing a line all the way back down through the finish. I'm still tasting it, just several.
That cherry flavor.
45 seconds afterwards, you're just still kind of sucking it down.
And definitely sour cherry.
Yes, yeah. Mm. What's kind of a cough drop, a lozenge, mm-hmm. You know, kind of flavor to it. But underneath that, there's some really nice kind of tobacco, you know, leathery kinds of qualities to it. Good tannins. They're very fine, though. Not overpowering at all, just kind of gripping the sides of your mouth. I can't emphasize enough the acidity of this wine, though. Like, it really is a really nice sour cherry.
Yeah, from a body standpoint, obviously, quite light body.
Mm-hmm.
The alcohol doesn't seem hot to me. It seems in balance.
No. Tannins are very present. I'd say maybe this wine's going to open up over the next 3 to 5 years. But it's just starting to come into its window right now. We actually were a little concerned this might be a little young, so we opened it a couple hours ago and then poured it back in the bottle. So it's been decanted, had some air, and it's still tasting incredibly strong and youthful even after being out in the air for a couple hours. Wow. Want to keep going?
Yeah, I think I agree with you. This could use some time.
Mm-hmm.
But still very good.
That's delicious. Willamette Valley, probably the fastest growing Pinot Noir region in the world, I'd say. A lot of new producers. This is actually one of the classics. This is Elk Cove's been around a long time. This is their, I think, yeah, this is their Five Mountain Pinot Noir, one of their single vineyard blends, their specialty blends. Much darker color off already. Still can see your hand through it, but we've definitely moved to almost a little violet around the edges, or, you know, like in the darker spots. Definitely a darker core to this.
It's almost bordering on that like brick color.
Yes. This is 2012 as well. This is a, let's see alcohol on this. This is 13.5, so we've just gone up 0.5% in alcohol. Not significant increase, especially for a New World wine. Still see that
the legs seem significantly.
Oh, they're coming. They're longer, but they're definitely coming down nice and quick, which they're not coated, so it's not coating the glass like you would expect a high alcohol wine to. See what it smells like. Ooh. Okay.
Wow.
Black cherry cola.
Raspberry.
And raspberry, like a raspberry jam just burst out of the glass. This is incredibly fruity.
Wow. Yeah.
This is, this smells like raspberry jam.
You like, nailed it with the black cherry cola. I can't get past that now.
kind of on the back end, I'm getting a little bit of the oak. Just a little milk chocolate, maybe. And then I'm getting a little black olive as well. I'm getting a little black olive in there. Try that. Or something.
I'm really getting that oak on the back there, like in like you said, milk chocolate. That actually really comes through.
Maybe it's a pruney kind of quality. Something like a little more cooked first, or fruitcake-y.
Yeah, almost a fig.
Yes, yeah, like a fig Newton. It kind of has a little fig Newton dusted with like cocoa powder. Let's give this a taste. I'm interested in what this going to taste like. So the fruit, very different on the palate than it is on the nose.
I'd say it tastes more like a fig Newton than anything else.
It definitely has more cooked and dried fruit on the palate. There's spice there.
Yeah, a lot
of spice coming through that I didn't catch on the nose. Again,
and the cherry and raspberry is not.
It's definitely faded a little bit.
As prevalent as it is in the nose.
You get.
Second time I got a lot more of the cherry than I did the first time.
There's still a ton of acidity here. It's more acidic than I thought it was going to be when we were smelling it. Like, it smells sweeter than it tastes. Definitely a classic Pinot Noir kind of flavor profile, but not overly juicy or, you know, fresh. It's not a fruit bomb. There's no question this is,
I get more cranberry in the taste.
You definitely get more of the tartness, that maybe would remind you of cranberry. I'm getting a little alcohol in the back. Not over the top. I feel like it's a little hotter.
Really, a much longer finish on this one than the last one.
Yeah, the tannins are down compared to the first one, mm-hmm. but the acidity is about equal but different flavors. I like this one. Again, very unique, very different in style very from unique. The first one. All right, I think we should move on. All right.
Yeah, that's nice.
All right. Costa Brown, 2013 Russian River Valley Pinot Noir. 2013, this is a 14.4 alcohol. Russian River Valley, a lot more sun there. Costa Brown's probably the most well-known Pinot Noir producer in California, or at least in Sonoma County. These guys are kind of superstars there. So this is, a lot like the last one, maybe a little lighter even than the last one.
I think it's lighter than the last one.
Yep. Less purple hues, more of that straight garnet flavor. Or
more transparent in there.
Mm-hmm. So you can see the alcohol already kind of coming down slow on those legs. Well, you can't, but I can, and you're just going to have to take my word for it. It definitely comes off a little thicker on the glass, I'd say. Yeah. This is a beautiful color, though. This is, for sure, I think, the brightest of the three.
Yeah, I would agree.
You know, this is a really, really pretty, pretty color. Pretty color. Let's see what it smells like. Okay, this is a classic Pinot Nose. This is, this is cherries, and then they put some cherries on top of your cherries.
I don't really get any oak in there.
No, I'm getting there's a little dark chocolate, a little bitter chocolate, bitter cocoa in there.
Yeah, I smell that.
It's a little tight. I was just gonna say it's tight. It's not very, it's not opening up very much.
Yeah, it's really hard to get over the cherry.
Yeah. Okay. Now some of the more raspberry and kind of bush fruit starting to come through a little bit as it opens up. All right, we're gonna smell, give it a taste.
Yeah, I think
Thinking
about nose fatigue now.
There you
so I'm
go.
Not
yeah,
get
that's
anything
right.
more.
Hey, actually, that's a really good point. You're gonna get about four smells out of a glass before your nose starts to go numb. So if you don't get it by then, give it a break. Take a taste. You're still smelling through your mouth. But yes, just so you don't go crazy over it. You don't have to. Easily the biggest of the wines.
Yeah.
Explosive cherry cordial flavor.
Cordial is a great way to
like chocolate covered cherry when that bursts in your mouth, like it's that kind of explosiveness to it.
It's got really good balance.
Yes. Yeah. The acidity, the tannins are there, they're present. These are lesser tannins than the first wine, more than the second, I would say. The alcohol's holding the whole thing up, but I don't taste it as being particularly hot. I can't tell you, like, there's a really nice cinnamon spice, kind of, like a baking spice kind of component that's coming through.
There's definitely some sort of spice in there.
Again, the cocoa's coming through again. This is... an intense wine.
I almost feel like I get a little bit of something nutty in there too.
this wine's played off the oak a little bit more. And that's bringing a little bit of that in there. But it's got all
the fruit. Smell that.
No, but it's got all the fruit to kind of back that up.
Yeah.
So, all right. So these are all kind of baller wines. We picked some good ones. These are all out of my cellar, and I wanted to, like, have some fun with it. So these are about $50 bottles, which if you're going to go out and buy good bottles of wine, Pinot Noir is a great grape to do that. Very hard to find value under $20 with Pinot Noir. And it's such a good food-friendly wine that for dinners and when you have to bring a bottle to an event, it's approachable for a lot of different people and it goes with a lot of different foods.
People who don't typically like red wine, this is still an approachable wine.
Yeah, this is definitely a place, especially if tannins are the problem.
Yeah.
This is definitely a wow wine. These are all three of these really qualify in that wow them wine. I mean, if you're a baller, it's a weekend wine. I get it, you know. But like for the rest of us, you know, 50 bones is a lot. And but if you have to, if you're meeting your in-laws for the, you know, or your hope, what you hope to be your in-laws for the first time, this is an outstanding bottle of wine to bring. All of these are drinking really well now. I do think the Druhan is early. Like, it's not in its full kind of, it's not peaking, probably not for another 3 to 5 years, I think, before it really shows what it's made of. The Elk Cove is drinking, I think, great right now. I think that this Costa's a little young. I think that it can grow out of, like, it'll grow and become more complex. It's so powerful with one or two notes right now. I feel like give it some time. It's got enough acidity, it's got enough alcohol to kind of hold on for a longer stretch. It'll be really, really delicious for the next 7 to 10 years, probably. What would you eat with this?
It's going to be a poultry, light, lean meat.
Yep.
You know, I think Thanksgiving is going to be the perfect time for these wines.
Thanksgiving, Christmas, Easter, any time, you know, all of those kinds of, like, anything from dark poultry to ham and kind of everything in between. I actually think that this Russian River could
that,
even...
That one's heavy enough, though, yeah.
I actually thought about lamb. Like, I think it's big enough for even lamb. It's. I would make a sauce out of that for
that sounds
for sure. But
really good.
yeah, I think that actually the bigger ones, this guy probably could hold up to pretty much anything you put in front of it. But the second and third ones, probably all, even pink fish is out. This one actually with salmon, I think you'd be fine. I think with salmon or trout, you could get away with. White fish is going to be, it's going to overpower quite a bit. Kind of depends a little bit on the sauce as well. I think if you are, you know, working the sauces in the direction of the wine, then that'll help. Who do you want to share this with?
This is for special company. This is for people you want to impress.
Or that you just love a lot.
Yeah. Exactly.
Like, all three of these bottles are
hold them near and dear and only share them with people that are important to you.
Yes. Wines. Or if you're in a lot of trouble with your wife. These are all three excellent bottles to break out. No, these are, if you need to do that $50 gift bottle, this is exactly the kind of bottle I would use. I think these are perfect for that. Who's going to love this wine? Yeah, if you drink red wine at all, if you're a cab, I don't care. At this level, these are delicious wines. I don't think it matters. If you don't like red wine, you'll still probably like these wines. I think we've gotten that. I think if you're really sensitive to acidity and you just like the really ripe fruits, these two guys might be a little tart, but I think we're stretching it there just to try to find somebody that might not like these. We'll do some more research, but I don't think that, I think if we put this in the tap back here, I don't think that we'd have any complainers. What's your score on these? Or I should say, which ones are getting wows?
The last two for sure. The first one, I think, like we talked about, is a little, could use some time, and I think in time could be a wow, but for now, it's probably just a yup.
Yeah. I'm going to go, actually, this is a really strong yup for me because I know what it's going to do. This is a yup, but I'm going to, there's a group of people who won't like this stewed fruit flavor, some of that stewed fruit that's coming through in that. There's a group of people that might be a turnoff for it. So it's not a wow for me. I would have liked it with less of that and more freshness. Still delicious. I'm nitpicking for sure. But this Russian River is an absolute wow. Coaster Brown knocked out of the park again. Absolutely delicious bottle. Let's not joke around. You're paying premium for all three of these bottles. Yep. But for the occasion, it's worth it. So that there's going to be four times this next year where you're going to need a bottle like this. Make sure you have one available to you because they are totally worth it. Anything else?
Those all three fantastic.
You guys are going to look for wines like this. You're going to like them. All right, until next time.
Worth the money, I would say.
It is worth the money when you need to put that kind of money down. I get it. Yeah, yeah. All right, until next time, thank you so much for tuning in. If you have any questions, if you have any concerns, if you want to know any more information, if you whatever you want to see next, put it in the notes below. We're going to keep doing these videos until somebody tells us to stop. Cheers.